All of these teams have played close throughout the season. We shouldn't expect anything less during the tournament.
Exactly like you said, a three-point game and 2 4-point games in the first round. Yesterday for this Peacock team, they really relied on the veteran Devontae Turner.
Devontae Turner, again, came up big in the second half. Had a slow start, I believe, in this game.
Winner go-home basketball, quarterfinal round of the 2019 MAAC basketball tournament, and we're underway. First game here in this tournament for the three-time defending champions from Iona.
Very important for St. Peter's not to allow Iona to get into the forerunner position where they're out and they're chasing.
Early aggressive move from junior Ben Perez falls short, and here comes St. Peter's. We mentioned Turner, but this guy, Dallas Watson, was fantastic yesterday.
Watson played very well. He made shots, feeding off of Turner, understanding there was a lot of double-team action on Turner, but he stepped up big.
Iona team that we know can score the basketball. How about this weird statistic? They scored and allowed the exact same number of points during the regular season, as right away offensive foul will be called on Quinn Taylor in foul trouble, something that hurt St. Peter's early in yesterday's game.
Really good job by Gist stepping in there, taking that charge. But the St. Peter's players, they need to stay on the floor. Their core group did a great job yesterday. They can't afford to be in foul trouble.
And they played a lot of minutes in that game yesterday, as Iona's going to pound it down low. Nice move by Tawan Agee.
Now on this Iona team, you have five guys who can give you 20 points at the blink of an eye. Agee is one of those guys. He has scary talent on this Iona team.
Third leading scorer, gets 13 a game for Iona.
And he's just scratching the surface.
McGill taking it away from Casey Nadefo. Perez, extra pass, Gist. They play catch on the right side. It's good transition defense from the Peacocks, as now Iona back into settled offense with a 2-0 lead. McGill will fire away and give Iona now a 5-0 advantage.
And that's why they're so tough, partner. In transition, St. Peter's does a good job getting back, but that secondary offense, that's not a play. They just swing the basketball around. Ricky McGill gets a good look, knocks it down.
Not a set play, but it's just great basketball, and that's what you get from the Gale. Shaheen Holloway calls timeout after Iona has jumped in front, making the first two field goals in this quarterfinal.
Good timeout early. You do not want Iona to get to a big lead, and as I said earlier, you don't want to be in chase mode.
After it was started off with an AG shot, look at the ball movement to McGill. And if Ricky McGill is consistent from outside, I don't know if anyone can beat Iona.
Well, Ricky doesn't do really one thing great. He's not a great shooter, not a great driver, doesn't have big-time athletic ability, but he does all of the small things. He's a winner, as you stated earlier. And what I love about him, he takes and makes big shots. He's been around for 4 years, but of the 3 years he's been here, all he knows is being in a championship game and winning.
Yeah, you said at our award show this morning, his head coach has a residency on Monday night.
Well, no doubt about it.
If Tim Kloos is in seat one, seat two is Ricky McGill.
And you know right behind him is A.J. Crawford.
That's a great point.
E.J. Crawford. I'm thinking of A.J. English.
And just all the guys that come from Iona who,
right,
who have won, right? That's the one thing that they seem to have in common.
At some point, they should call it Guard U.
St. Peter's still looking for their first field goal attempt as Iona's knocked down two of its first three. There's a paint touch for Sammy Dowu. Has to kick it out. Shot clock to one. And it'll be a violation. The shot went in, but it won't count. Turnovers for the first couple of Peacocks possessions.
Very good defense there by Iona. Their defense is underrated because they score the ball so well. But when they get ready, they can clamp down. For St. Peter's, I think it's important to get Sam involved. And you want Turner to get off early. Those two guys are so important. Their senior year, they have to leave it all on the floor.
Iona gets a lot of press, and deservedly so, for a prolific offense. But like you said, and this foul will be Taylor's second, will send Crawford to the line. They play championship defense, as in when you get to this MAAC tournament, it could be man, it could be zone. They just get stops.
They have a system that works very well during the regular season. There are a couple of coaches in this league, Coach Kloos is one, who understand exactly what it takes to win in the tournament, and these guys really get it defensively and on the offensive end.
Taylor will sit down with two fouls, and in will check freshman Manny Dixon. Had some nice moments for this St. Peter's team in that come-from-behind win yesterday over Marist.
I thought Dixon had some big shots in that second half, was not afraid at all.
The two Crawford free throws now push the Iona lead to 7-0, and they'll extend pressure. Now, Turner was slow to get started in that game yesterday with Marist. I don't think he's going to have that luxury tonight, Chris. I think he's going to have to get going early.
Not at all. I won't be surprised that he puts up a shot on his possession.
A strong move from freshman Casey Nadefo, and he gets in the scoring column for St. Peter's.
As I said in the opening, Ricky McGill very good with that lead pass to get things started. Not a set play. It starts the transition where you can get into your secondary offense where Crawford's able to knock down the three.
Silky smooth release from the first team all-league honoree, E.J. Crawford. Here's Turner, lost the dribble, able to get it back, and that's a beautiful floater over A.G.
I like it, partner. Be aggressive, Turner. Take it to the cup. Get shots up.
Iona started this one on fire. They've made three of their first four. A.G.'s going to test the range, too, and this one will fall right to Turner.
Defense totally different that was played on Turner from yesterday. Think he'll get better looks than he had yesterday.
Turner and McGill, a couple of veterans in this league. Look at Turner get loose in the lane. Get the friendly roll.
They must have some sort of wire from here to the bench, or these guys understand exactly what I'm talking about. You need Turner to get into that lane, be aggressive, put pressure on that Iona defense so they are aware that he's ready to rock this evening.
You think they're piped into the broadcast?
I think so. I think so.
Idowu and AG. The turnaround. And St. Peter's will try to further cut into the early Iona lead. Gales jumped in front 7-0. St. Peter's has kind of settled this one down on the back of this guy, Turner, and he is fouled. Great start to this game offensively. For the three-time defending champion, the Gales from Iona. They jumped in front 7-0. They lead 10-6. Dialing up from distance is now underway. Still no really early looks for Idowu, but Turner has gotten it going early. And there's Watson continuing his strong MAAC tournament.
Big-time shot there by Watson. Had a solid basketball game last night. Stepping up there, defense sloughs off. He pulls up the three ball, nails it.
It was Watson who really carried the offensive load for the St. Peter's team in the first half against Marist. There's A.G. down low, creating space and one.
Strong move by A.G. established great position down low. Sam underneath the basket, only two things can happen. You're either going to get fouled and scored. In this case here, he got both.
Idowu coming down, and how about the spin and the English that A.G. able to put on the basketball?
He may have gotten away with a traveling violation, but he's at the free throw line looking for an and one. Now, this young man, as I stated earlier, has scary talent. Watched him during the warm-up. He can knock down the three ball, has a really great touch. As you see, knocks that free throw down. Good footwork. His issue is most of the time keeping his head in the basketball game.
With the leadership on that team, McGill and company, you figure that's something that they take on themselves. And there's Perez in the passing lane. He tried to throw it to Crawford. Nadefo and Turner were back.
Casey's doing a really good job getting back on defense.
And Turner has his shot blocked, but the foul was called first. And they're going to rule that on the floor with 14:57 to go in the first.
And again, that's the hustle play you have to have from St. Peter's. Get back on defense, allows Turner to play downhill. He needs to be in downhill mode for the entire basketball game, taking no plays off.
Perez will sit down. Iona will check in. 6'11 redshirt freshman Andrea Rastanovich. We mentioned at the top of the program that Tim Kluse honored as the coach of the year for the second time. You know, this Iona team won the outright regular season title for the first time since 2014-15. And, Chris, they brought back just two players that won a championship last year.
And it's so interesting that you state that. You would think this team year in and year out, a legal screen call there, would be at the top of the league, because when you think of MAAC basketball, most of the time you think of the Iona Gales. But they turn it up in the tournament. These guys understand there's a process, there's a system that they apply, and it has been working year in and year out.
And the ability to fit guys into that, whether they're four-year players, one-year, two-year guys. You know, we do broadcasts during the year and during the regular season. I compared it to the New England Patriots just for their ability to fit people into the system they run. A.G., oh, what a block. It was Woods and Adefo that met him, and here comes Watson.
Casey's so good on that defensive end.
And this offensive foul will go on Derek Woods, discarding Tawan A.G.
Good, strong move. Help side defense right there by KC, using his athletic ability. Goes straight up, gets all basketball.
Well, in yesterday's game, Nadefo had four blocks, and he's got one today. His blocks aren't just normal blocks either. They are emphatic, athletic plays.
Looking forward to seeing the development of this young man. Again, has a slight frame right now, but he plays so fearless.
McGill to the couple dribble pull-up. And then he's underneath, but the loose ball foul will send it the other way. They'll call it on Asante Gist. So the junior from East Orange, New Jersey, will pick up his second foul, and he'll have to sit down.
Ben Perez comes right in. You talk about a guy like Ben Perez. He's really one of those glue guys on the Iona team. Makes the great pass, very solid, unselfish. He can score 20, but he's usually one of those guys more comfortable just taking shots that he knows he can make.
Watson long on his three, and there's Crawford underneath. AG, who set the screen, will pitch it back to McGill. Two-man game. There's Watson to rip it away. Here goes Dallas Watson, the bounce to Dixon. Great adjustment in midair.
Great defense by Watson, coming up with the steal. Good transition move. I like the English put on that layup to close it out.
The St. Peter's young guys, Nadefo and Dixon and Watson, having really good tournaments. Crawford into the corner to Rustanovich, whose three is long. And here comes St. Peter's now, down just two after trailing 7-0. And Turner took maybe one too many, and we'll go the other way.
St. Peter's playing with a lot of energy right now early on. I like the downhill call for the turnover. Turner's going out right now, but you want him playing fast. He's going to take a seat because he just played last night a lot of minutes, so you're going to make sure you preserve this young man.
He played 44 minutes in that overtime.
That's a lot of minutes. Keep in mind, everyone watching, it was an overtime basketball game that they were in.
Averages about 36 minutes a game during the season. And then, as my partner said, he played 44 of those 45 possible minutes in yesterday's overtime game.
Again, another good defensive effort. Iona, a little slow start here. They came out quickly, but right now the pace is going towards St. Peter's.
Well, Iona started on that 7-0 scoring run, and since then they've turned it over and haven't scored in the last 2-plus minutes. Well, St. Peter's, they've got 6 turnovers, Chris, but they just got to get shots at the rim. They're 5-for-7 from the floor.
And you know what? Those are aggressive turnovers.
Nadefo aggressive, and he'll go to the line.
Nadefo is fearless. Again, he's listed as, what, 6'5"? This guy goes to the post there, goes strong, draws a foul.
Well, you can be 6'5 and play in the post when you can jump out of the gym. This is a nice move and a patient move from the freshman.
Goes right at Maxwell. Good footwork to get to the inside to draw the contact.
Free throws coming for Ndefo. Shoots him at 64%.
Well, he's listed as 6'6", but most of the time when you're around 6'5", 6'6", it looks the same. I'm 6'4". Once in a while, you may think I'm 6'6".
What do you think? If you said you were 6'6", I wouldn't bat an eye.
Gotcha.
That's why I wear the hair so high, so I can get close.
And what does the hair make you?
I'm about 6'1 with the hair.
I like it. I like it.
Nadefo's 2. Tie the game at 13. So St. Peter's has erased that 7-0 start to this game. With 12 and a half to go here in the first. There's McGill catching it on the run, pulling up, and able to get the friendly roll.
Iona going to that weave. A lot of teams have success with that, especially when it gets really quickly. defensively, you have to figure out if you want to switch or go man-to-man. McGill figuring out exactly where there's a spot, gets to that mid-range, knocks it down.
Dixon has to save it inbounds. He's able to do so to Watson. Watson being aggressive, and he'll earn a trip to the free throw line. A possession look almost like a busted one, but good hustle from Manny Dixon.
Another good move by Watson, getting into the paint. Paint touches are so
coming for Dallas Watson. Yeah, they go on, let's call those championship runs, and they know how to do it. Another free throw for the talented freshman from Brooklyn. Tied up again. That'll get Turner back in. A brief rest for Devontae Turner. He'll take out Watson.
And that's so important to get these guys rest when it's an opportunity. If you notice, you get rest close to a timeout so you can get some additional time on that bench.
Iona breaking the pressure, and Perez will earn a trip to the free throw line.
Perez being aggressive. Usually an outside shooter, but he's going to the cup there to earn himself two free throws. Anytime you get to that line, see that ball go through the basket, that helps that outside shot.
Perez, a good shooter, shoots it well from three, shoots 79% from the free throw line.
You got him.
I know.
Never fails.
I'll make sure to apologize to Ben after the game. It's that fine line between giving the information and the jinx. And you know what? It's probably I did it too late. I should have did it earlier.
You gotta give the fella some love because he's a good free throw shooter. See, I didn't get him here.
That's a good point. Close one here in the first half. Times Union Center, Albany, New York. First of two quarterfinals here tonight, and then the other two are tomorrow. Turner, oh, it's a strong move to the basket for Devontae Turner.
I'm feeling Turner being aggressive. Didn't settle for that shot there. Got deep into the lane.
Well, he has no trouble just throwing his body around. Under control, though. Very impressive.
He said last night his favorite player is Allen Iverson. Plays fearless just like him.
There's AG. He's fouled as both Clay Brown and Woods were there. They'll call it on Clay Brown, the freshman from Queens.
Clay Brown on the floor for the first time. He started off this game coming off the bench, obviously, but he didn't play much last night. I don't think he got into the basketball game, but it's important for a guy like him to come in and sustain and be good on the floor for a couple of minutes.
Well, that's what Dixon did right in the game last night. Manny Dixon with AG at the line. He came in, had good moments, hit a couple of shots, and earned himself more playing time.
Clay has good size, 6'4", from Queens.
Yeah, the New York City bragging rights that must be discussed among the St. Peter's players. Unbelievable when you see the storied high school programs that they come from.
Right, Clay played at Lincoln High School. Tremendous amount of history from that school.
Yeah, do yourself a favor. I was getting ready for the game. I started looking at the alums from the high schools.
Oh, my goodness.
My goodness. The Wikipedia page.
I won't
page,
even start Lincoln.
It's unbelievable. Here is Brown. Going to go down low. Woods. Shot clock down to five. Brown's going to pull up. And there's Taylor. He seems to win a lot of 50-50 balls for St. Peter's, doesn't he?
Those are the balls you have to have. Didn't mind the shot there by Brown. Just didn't like the hesitation. Take it the first time.
St. Peter's trailed 7-0, tying this game up. Woods spinning right into AG, and that'll be a charge.
Great job in the post defensively. I like the defense by Maxwell, which turned him right back into AG, drawing that offensive foul.
And you got to be in great position to draw that, and AG was right where he needed to be.
Woods thinks he has good position. He spins when he sees that one defender, AG right there to draw the charge.
And thankfully not hurt because those elbows were coming in high. Crawford sizing it up, and E.J. Crawford knocks down his second three from straight away.
E.J. Crawford is a matchup nightmare. 6'6 lefty, can knock down the three ball, gets to the cup, and he's a lefty, which helps out everything.
18 a game for the junior from Hartford, Connecticut. You could tell right when he stepped on the court as a freshman he was going to be good, and he has just consistently developed every year.
Ideal player that fits well in this Iona system.
Inside out look. Turner's going to pull up just inside the free throw line. There's Taylor again down low, and Quinn Taylor makes it a one-point game.
Taylor back on the floor with two fouls. Again, he comes up with the big 50-50 balls, as you stated. Rebound there, put back.
Fair to say he plays a lot bigger than his 6'4 frame?
No question about it.
It's a great move down low. Crawford starting to feel it.
Crawford mixing up. He knocked down the three ball previously. That time goes to the post. That's why he's such a tough matchup.
He's got 10 here in the first half.
It's a quiet 10.
Yeah, it is. Our first player in double figures is the Iona lead is 3. In the passing lane, Perez again, but there's that guy again, Quinn Taylor. Turner the pull-up. And Dowu can't secure it. It'll go back over to the Gales.
Well, Sam was unable to get that rebound, but he's the one guy I like to see get on track also. Didn't have a big offensive night, but I like him in that post, and he can stretch it out as a stretch four because he can knock down shots, but he needs to be a little bit more aggressive also with Turner.
Just 8 points in 34 minutes last night, but Idowu, he fits into that matchup nightmare category as well.
Yes,
averages
indeed.
11. Here's Crawford. Two Peacocks run at him, and then A.G. able to knock it down.
A.G. at 6'8", going outside, knocking down that three ball with a nice touch.
Just as quickly as it was tied, Iona's made 4 shots in a row to lead by 6. Here's Watson going to drive on McGill, and look at Ricky McGill, the veteran, getting position and earning the charge call.
Championship defense there by Ricky McGill. Again, too much bouncing there by Watson, especially with the defense set.
You called it perfectly. He does a little bit of everything well.
And he's going one-on-one defense right there waiting for him. Uses that chicken wing, extends that. Anytime that happens, that gives the official the liberty to give that call.
Gil just makes winning plays on the basketball court, regardless of which end of the floor it has to happen on. Imagine the confidence winning 3 tournament championships gives to you.
Man, that is great. I had to fight to get the one I have. And this guy walks in here, gets 3 real quick.
Looking for ring number 4, and he's got some help. Has that edge to him, and AG just fit right in.
He's the JC transfer that usually comes in and year out for Iona that really gets him over the hump.
Idowu able to tip it to himself. It's amazing how they just infuse those guys into their program.
Iona in the matchup zone.
Taylor, the start and stop, and that's a good move from Quinn Taylor. He'll earn the free throws after he's fouled from Jonathan Maxwell.
Taylor found a soft spot right in the middle of the zone, made a quick decision. Goes straight to the cup. Not a lot of communication between the defensive players there. And you have to make sure you're talking in the zone so everybody knows what's going on. If you ever go to an NBA basketball game and you compare the sound to a college basketball game, totally different. At the NBA level, everyone is talking,
right,
communicating. Good college basketball teams do the same thing, but on average, most teams don't talk as much as they need to.
Yeah, great point. As Taylor goes 1 for 2. Yeah, at a game, right, more times than not, there's, especially at that level, there's more talking in between the lines than there is typically in the stands. The only place there's more talking is the broadcast table.
You
really
got it. Well, you know you and I are going to definitely talk. That's a given.
We'll communicate. We'll be good. Little two-man game. Crawford and his 10 first half points. Backing down Turner. And look at the defense from Devontae Turner.
Turner being really tough in that post. I thought Crawford did a great job being patient, trying to exploit that matchup.
Crawford, the size advantage, but don't tell that to Devontae Turner.
Well, you said it yesterday, pound for pound, he may be the toughest player in the league.
And we see him challenge bigger guys all the time, and not just going to the rim, but plays like that defensively.
And I think we're being generous saying he's 6 feet tall. He might be a little bit smaller.
6:38 to go here in a well-played first half. There's some fans filing in. Those are Canisius fans awaiting the second quarterfinal tonight between Canisius and the Manhattan Jaspers.
Tough shot by Watson coming off that screen.
Watson shooting it very well here in Albany this week. Up to 7 first half points. He's leading the way for St. Peter's as they just hang around. There's McGill on the other side. What a look and a massive throwdown. Look out below to one, AG.
Wow, big rebound by Ricky McGill. But as I stated earlier, this young man has scary talent. Forced a bad shot. Ricky gets that rebound, sees his partner. Look out below, headshot.
The whole play really made McGill saw the air ball, knew where his teammate was going to be, and oh wow, AG bringing everyone to their feet. So we've seen a little bit of everything from the junior. We've seen the step out three. Now we've seen his ability to be strong inside, and he's into double figures with 12. See if St. Peter's can respond to that play. Chris, that's one of those emotion plays we talked about in our broadcast yesterday.
Watching St. Peter's again, they are not rattled at all. Came right back, got the ball in that post there. Sam unable to finish, but he gets fouled.
Well, that's a good job by Idowu, who knows he missed an easy one, but not putting the head down, sticking with it, and he'll go to the free throw line.
It's important after a play like that, getting your composure.
Well, you've got to keep composure after something like this happens against you, and just dropping the hammer is AG.
There's nothing you can do. Sometimes you just have to let that one go. You have to let that one go.
Yeah, I give credit to he and Turner having a nice conversation underneath. I give credit to anyone who tries to get in front of a dunker, because I would seek out shelter in a situation like that.
Well, one thing I always tell people who ask questions about, well, Smooth, have you ever been dunked on? Of course I have. If you've never been dunked on, there's two reasons why. You're not playing with good enough players, and you don't play defense.
That's a good
point. I didn't play a lot of defense, but I did play with good players.
That's a good point. If anyone says no, they're just lying or didn't play a whole lot of basketball.
You got it. And to the flip side of that, I've caught my share of people also, Eddie O.
Oh, it's a two-way street.
I've caught some bodies also.
Can't claim I ever have.
I think you've tagged up on some people in there.
That 6-foot rim is a beautiful thing. Crawford going right into the body of Idowu. That's good defense from Sam Idowu down low. Again, St. Peter's just hanging around in this game. Iona's shooting almost 50%, but Peacock's right there. Watson pulls up. AG's feeling it a little bit. He sets the screen for McGill. Gisty's checked back in with those couple of fouls. Another big block. Idowu sending it back. Taylor back the other way. And he was out of bounds when it came down.
Great job by Sam on two defensive plays, protecting the rim, patrolling that lane area. Again, you need that. Gist thought he had an easy layup. He got past the one defender. Sam right there met him at the glass there in transition. St. Peter's unable to finish.
St. Peter's has a couple of rim protectors in Idowu and Nadefo who make life hard when you get into the paint. It's an open look for McGill. And then an over-the-back foul will go on Rastanovic.
Casey working so hard, doing a great job blocking out. Unable to come up with the rebound, but he'll earn himself a trip to the free throw line. Good move to get himself in the lane. He's deep. Sam right there waiting for the help side.
We've talked about the Iona success, but in a weird way. These two can't avoid each other in the postseason. This is the third straight year that they've met. The previous two were in the semis. This one is to get to the semifinals. And we mentioned Ricky McGill, but Devontae Turner's played in those. Quinn Taylor's played in those. Sammy Doe's played in those. Chris, there's a lot of major minutes logged in the MAAC tournament on the floor both ways.
Well, if you talk to each team to a man, they would understand this is a tough matchup for both teams. If you're Iona, in contrast, St. Peter slows everything down. They grind you out. They make the pace much slower than Iona wants. And if you're St. Peter's, you're saying, well, listen, Iona wants to run, and they have those spurts that can kill you at any time because oftentimes St. Peter's has inability to score the basketball. So which side can really prevail? And right now St. Peter's doing a really good job staying in this basketball game, just hanging around, and you have the advantage of having Turner who can possibly make a big shot for you.
McGill comes right back as soon as St. Peter's cut it to two to knock the jumper down.
And you talk about big shots. Ricky McGill gets right to his spot, foul line extended area, pulls up, knocks down the shot.
He has possessions like that where he just says, I'm taking this, guys. And that's the senior being a leader. St. Peter shooting 50%. They're 9 out of 10 from the free throw line as well, helping keep them in this game. Nadefo knocks down the three.
Great job by Sam. The defense had really got into the lane area. He had no choice but to take it, shot it with confidence.
McGill comes right back and puts in the long two.
Ricky McGill starting to heat up. Nice quick move. Again, mid-range. That wasn't a three.
Shaheen Holloway calling out instructions to his backcourt. 3:25 to go here in the first. Turner's going to attack from the baseline. He puts it in and one.
Another strong move by Turner, attacking the cup, going right at the big fella. That could have been close to a charge, but he sacrificed his body, earning himself a chance to go to the free throw line, looking for another and one. AG thought he had a charge there, loved this expression, but keeping his composure, which is good for Iona.
Emotion's a great thing when kept in check. As Turner able to tie this one up at 32, much faster start to this game for Devontae Turner than yesterday when he just had two in the first half, already 9 points.
Solid first half here for St. Peter's. You like Turner starting off quickly.
There's Giss with the shot clock down to 8. Crawford, the catch and shoot off balance three is pure.
He's such a tough customer. Line drive three, nails it, telling the official he may have got hit on the hand, but he was still able to make the shot.
E.J. Crawford, just a shot maker. 50% from the floor, 38% from three, a tremendous free throw shooter. Really no holes in his game offensively.
Professional score.
Latter stages here in the first half. Nadefo exploding to the rim, and he'll have a chance for an and one.
Another fearless drive, avoiding the charge because of his athletic ability. KC showing great bounce to finish that play. Off of one bounce from the three-point line, gets all the way to the rim.
An impressive young player, KC Nadefo, having himself a MAAC tournament.
If you're a St. Peter's fan, you have to be excited about these young guys playing fearless here in this tournament. Obviously, didn't have great season, but they understand they can beat everybody in this competition, meaning the tournament.
Yeah, once you get here, once you get to the Times Union Center in Albany, all bets are off, right? You can have anything happen pretty much. At least till Monday night.
Right. Usually your main concern is your young players because you're not sure how they're going to react in this setting here.
Well, every time Iona seems to get that brief lead, St. Peter's with an answer. Perez, that's a great pass to Maxwell. A little too far under the basket. And Adiowu tips it over to Turner. See if the Peacocks can take a lead as they've made three in a row.
You notice how off of the defensive stand, St. Peter's doesn't push it unless they have something. Controlling the tempo.
There's Idowu down low, gathering, and there is a St. Peter's lead. That's their first lead in about 10 minutes.
That's what I was looking for on the previous play. I thought Sam had a favorable matchup. That time they went straight to him and he went strong to the cup.
McGill exploding to the basket. And that's what Ricky McGill does when his team needs a play. He's there to make it.
Guess who? Ricky McGill. Big time play, strong to the cup, help side defense wasn't there just yet. As soon as Ricky gets it, he goes straight to the basket. Defense wasn't there. Late, he gets fouled.
Called upon to be more of a scorer this year. McGill gets 16 a game. Another strong half. He's got 11.
Just think about the different guards that Ricky's been able to play with. Talked about A.J. English, big-time scorer. Ricky was on a team with him. Understanding what it takes to be a winner. Cashmere played with him a couple of years. All these guys could score the ball. Ricky can score it also, but understanding playing with them, he wasn't the main guy.
He's done it all, whether he was the complimentary guy, the main guy, or just missing a steal here. Good deflection from Peyton Hudson, who just checked in. Crawford to the cross. Good transition defense. McGill will fire up a three.
All started with that advanced pass. That advanced pass is so important for Iona. It starts off their transition and it gets them into a secondary opportunity.
Inside of a minute to go in the first half. Watson down low, Idowu lost it, gathered it, and there's Sammy Idowu being impactful.
Sam doing a great job keeping the defender on his back. Again, a deep post up, Watson delivers. Again, when the defender's behind you, only two things can happen, either a foul or a score. Sam puts it in, St. Peter's up by one.
How about this first half? Three-time defending champion Iona jumps in front 7-0. St. Peter's battles back. This has been a little bit of everything, partner, here in the first. And how about the resolve of this St. Peter's team kind of weathering that early storm to now take a lead?
Considering St. Peter's played a really tough game last night, not a lot of time to prepare, not a lot of time to recuperate. These guys are just out here balling, understanding the things they need to do. Control the tempo, take advantage of matchup opportunities. You want your two top players, Turner and Sam, to be aggressive, and they've done all of that thus far in this first half.
Well, there's another game tonight, but before that second quarter final, our mascots are going to play at
halftime. I like the mascots. That Canisius mascot looks tough, boy.
Got a little.
The golden griff.
Got a little movement to the griff. Inside of 30 seconds here in this first half. Maxwell, a high arcing three. And great hustle from the freshman, Clay Brown. And if St. Peter's chooses, they'll take the final shot of the first half already with a one-point lead in hand.
Again, that's a shot St. Peter's would live with. Maxwell taking a three was on target. Unable to make it, but coming out of timeout, you would think McGill or Crawford would take a shot.
Here's Turner, gonna go with two, and unable to get anything going towards the rim. Okay, number nine seed St. Peter's with a one-point lead over the MAAC Coach of the Year, Tim Cluse's Iona Gales. With Manhattan Hall of Famer Chris Williams, I'm Eddie Acapinti. And all right, partner, you've won a MAAC championship. Iona knows what it takes to win a MAAC championship. Right now, they're in a fight for their lives, however, as we begin the second.
Well, yes, sir. Coming out in the second half, most teams make adjustments. Let's see if St. Peter's can sustain a run by Iona.
Right out of the break, Watson's three is short, and he had a strong first half with seven, but Iona getting a stop, not even 20 seconds into our second half.
Looks like that was a set play, ran for Watson to come off to shoot the three.
Iona getting an early touch for AG, and it's defended well by Idowu on this possession.
Really good position defense by Sam, throwing AG off balance.
Take a look, St. Peter's had a very balanced scoring first half. They had a handful of players getting to that score column. Iona only had four guys score, albeit three of them in double figures. The Peacocks have gotten contributions from a handful of players. Turner, the ball in his hands. Shot clock to three to the pull-up. And it goes over the top and back to Iona.
tough shot, two tough shots by St. Peter's. If you're a St. Peter's fan, you like to see that ball get into the post. You want Sam to get some touches. You ended off that first half with him getting great looks in the paint.
You know, a strong end to that first half for the senior big man, Idowu. Minute and a half gone by. Want to post AG again. He catches it deeper this time. Spins towards the baseline side, and that is just too tough for Tawan AG.
Key word, catching that ball deep, established great position. At his height at 6'9", able to go right over Sam.
AG feeling it here. He's had a strong game, a team high 14. Now Perez stepping in front of Idowu, and he wants to run. Throwing it ahead to Gist. Gist goes the other way, and there's Nadefo.
Casey once again with a huge block. He would have blocked that on either side of the rim.
I really think, Chris, he just takes off and then figures it out in midair. It's amazing.
And he plays with an angry demeanor.
Idowu double teamed. Ball staying on the left side of the floor as Watson, the contested two, is good for Dallas Watson.
Dallas made that much tougher than he had to, but he knocks down a big shot there.
And there's Nadefo, more impactful plays on the defensive end.
Using his athleticism and his length so well.
Miguel kind of got caught up, and now St. Peter's will try to build on a one-point lead. Idowu, that's a nice step through for Sam Idowu.
Beautiful job finding him inside the paint area. Great touch inside the lane. He was so deep also.
And back the other way, Gist pulls up, and he's fouled by Taylor. It'll be three free throws and a kind of deflating play if you're St. Peter's, as Asante Gist will go to the line.
Transition again. Gist feeling the pressure from KC, but like I said, he would have blocked that on either side of the rim. Very reminiscent of LeBron James blocking the shot on Andre Iguodala in the championship. Again, most players understand use that rim as a shield to protect the block, but when you have guys that athletic, they control both sides, and he was able to block that shot.
I mean,
that reminiscent
is,
now.
It was unbelievable. Nadefo took off expecting to use his right hand,
right,
and had enough air under him, in midair, mind you, to say, oh, he's going the other way. Let me get the left hand involved. That's a special play. You don't see that often.
Big time bounce.
Another free throw coming for Gist, as he's a 76% shooter. Did miss the first one.
Well, you have to give Gist credit on that play. As a guard, a small guard, you are taught to use that rim and go to the opposite side.
Well, you talked about McGill being a guy not afraid to take and make big shots, and I know it's a small sample size, but some of the games I covered this year, Asante Gist has that in him as well.
He's in the same mode. He is definitely in the same mode.
After those two Gist free throws, the Peacocks lead by one.
Iona turning up the defense. Like the work down low. Look at that defense by AG.
And then he takes it away from Watson. His bullet ahead, intercepted by Idowu. The turnover is it's just a back-breaking play.
Coach Holloway imploring Turner to be aggressive. He had an opportunity to go straight to the cup, and he laid back.
Well, here goes now Turner. He's going to create space with the step back three, and there's Devontae Turner again.
Turner said, well, listen, coach, if I didn't take it to the basket, I'm going to step back and give you a three, and we'll get one more.
How about a four-point St. Peter's lead? And there's AG just muscling it up and in.
Strong move. I thought that was good defense by Sam. Better offense by AG. Keep an eye on the disposition of AG. You don't want him to get too high. He's starting to bark a little bit.
Game high 16 for Tawan AG. And the foul here with 15:37 remaining.
Players touching it, more guys don't have an opportunity to feel good about themselves. That's why the tempo is so important for St. Peter's to keep it slow.
I think you make a great point. People throw the word around without truly understanding how it impacts a game. Idowu off the window, and they build on that lead.
Sam throwing his body around in that post area, once again getting great position. Look how quickly Iona comes right back at you, Ricky McGill.
They quickly transition to offense. Sammy Dowu picks up the foul. It'll be his second. So free throws coming for first team all-league recipient, Ricky McGill. And just look at the numbers as well. When you see 9 versus 1, regardless of what conference you're talking about, you know how 9 can stay in a game against 1 regardless? They shoot 60%, and that's what St. Peter's is doing.
And that is a great thing, and it's more so about taking good quality shots, great looks. Paint touches are big for St. Peter's.
Dowu now in a double figures, joining Nadefo and Turner. McGill goes 1 out of 2.
Guess who comes up with that rebound? This young fella is playing out.
Defo, the Elmont, New York native, also played his ball at Lincoln in Brooklyn. Is he Dowu? He's good handle for a big man. Dixon a bit too much dribbling, and he turns it over. There's McGill, sees the middle of the floor open, and there's Nadefo again. And then Turner able to win a 50-50 ball. And St. Peter's can hold it up.
Casey is all over those block shots, running the floor with another huge block in transition.
And then he commits the offensive foul. He discarded McGill with the offhand. The veteran McGill getting that call, but Chris, he's doing it again.
Can he just track that down? Good help side defense underneath, but he goes up high to get the block. Now, that's a ticky-tack foul. I would have to say that. Because it's right in front of us in the open, I guess the official makes that call, but you can let that be a play on.
Dowu rebounding the Crawford miss. I'll tell you what Nadefo and Dowu are doing down low. They're really going to make you think twice about getting into the paint, getting to the basket, because you either got the big man in front of you, and you have to look over both shoulders if Nadefo's chasing you down.
That's part of solid defense. Big foul here on AG. I'm sorry, that's on Gist. I thought that was on AG.
Well, it's a crucial call either way because it was going to be one of those players' third fouls. Iona probably a little fortunate it's not AG as it'll go on Gist.
Coach Clusa likes to allow Gist to stay in the ball game.
Loose ball foul here on the inbounds. McGill and Turner battling for it. It's Ricky McGill's first foul.
Well, that's a really good job by Turner holding off McGill. I thought he had a great read on that play because that would have been similar to a pick six. He gets that steal. He's going to be in the open court for a layup. You like that football reference in there real quick, huh?
I love it. I love it. I sometimes, I think, go too far with that, so I try to.
Well, you do both.
I do both.
I know my homework with my partner.
Iona defense going to extend out a bit. They throw over the top of it. Idowu able to bring it down. There's Nadefo. That athleticism again making an impact, keeping another possession alive.
And that is huge.
3-point St. Peter's lead. Turner looking for more.
Turner once again downhill, screen to the right, elected not to use it, went to his left.
Big possession here out of the Tim Clues timeout for Iona. See where they go. Crawford trying to muscle up the lefty shot, and he rolls it in.
It's ironic that Crawford scores that basket during that break. You said smooth. What does Iona do? You have two first-teamers, as I stated to you, on this side of the basketball. I'm looking for Crawford and McGill to play big to close this basketball game out.
And a big answer from E.J. Crawford, who's up to 15 points. There's Dixon going to get into the paint, and he rebounds his own miss.
Excellent job by Dixon. Sam is starting to be double-teamed. He's going to have to pass that ball out. Guys have to be ready to shoot or drive to the cup.
Crawford in the post for the second consecutive possession. And there's a whistle down low. Idowu, some brief contact, and then AG ran away. It'll be foul number three on Samuel Idowu.
That may be a blessing in disguise. I'll tell you exactly why. There was a one-on-one matchup with Crawford and Turner, which is a size mismatch. Turner had been able to post up on that last possession. He was looking to get more.
Gilda inbound, 12:41 to go here in the second half. 5 points, St. Peter's lead. Crawford being aggressive. Tries the rebound, is missed. He does. Can't get the stick back. AG to the rim. No whistle. And not on the first one, but on the second one.
Good job by Iona, just keeping that basketball alive. St. Peter's being so scrappy on the defensive end.
There's a lot to digest here, partner.
AG gets to the cup there. No contact call there. He gets the rebound. Actually, that play looked clean, but he's going to earn himself two free throws. That replay didn't do justice for the officials.
Yeah, a lot going on there. Still waiting to see who they credited that foul to. AG will have another one coming.
Again, I stated earlier, keep an eye on the disposition of AG. You want this guy to be tuned in, engaged in his basketball game. You don't want him to go too high on the negative side and you lose him.
They call the foul on Turner. It's his second. AG able to knock down a pair to make it 52-49. Now Iona will extend that pressure. Turner and McGill, how about that matchup?
Iona going to a trapping type defense, trying to get the ball out of the hands of Turner.
They run the double team at him after the Idowu screen. Shot clock down to four. Nadefo, that's a great one-on-one move, but he lost it on the way up.
Ricky McGill with the quick hands at the last moment. Maul the game, meaning make it a situation where they don't have enough time to go on that real big spurt.
Another football reference, trying to shorten the game
up?
Yes,
indeed.
I love it. There's Crawford, the pull for three, and there's Turner down low to clear it.
In essence, St. Peter's wants to go to their running game. They don't want to pass the ball. I'm killing you with the football references.
I love it. I love it. I'm going to have to give you a call in the fall. 13 on the shot clock. There's Turner. Big rebound by Quinn Taylor. And it's stripped out of bounds. It'll stay with St. Peter's.
You talked about Taylor coming up with big plays in that first half. That rebound was huge, not necessarily because he was able to score the ball, but they get another possession to take some time off that clock.
Goes to your previous point, right? It's really time of possession, if you will. Watson running around a screen. The big man's going to step out. And Crawford will watch it go out of bounds.
Sam has the ability to make that shot, but he's been so good in that paint.
Third straight year these two teams have met in the postseason. Both times prior in the semifinals. This one in the quarters. Last year, St. Peter's defeated 8th seed Monmouth, then knocked off top seed Ryder. And they knock off a top seed again. There's Idowu to corral the rebound.
That's a shot St. Peter's will definitely live with from AG from the outside. Kloos going with the zone with the big fella up top.
More of that 1-3-1 look. We saw Crawford playing up top there early in the second half. Right opposite look. There's Taylor able to finish.
Beautiful pass by Dixon. Head up. Got the ball all the way through the defense from the top of the key to the baseline.
AG this time with that elbow catch. The spin is going to go back, and that is a wild shot that falls for AG.
Again, I thought Sam played great position defense. Beautiful move by AG. This guy has a special talent.
He's made a couple of those in this game. One possession. Midway point, second half. Don't go anywhere, everyone. We've got a good one. Owen Watson just lost it out of bounds off his hands.
Just turning up the defense over there on Watson.
See where Iona goes. AG's got 20. Crawford's got 15. And they give it to him right at the free throw line. And there's E.J. Crawford to make it a one-point game.
Easy money for him. In that position there, all he has to do, turn and face, flick of a wrist. That young man there is a professional scorer.
That may be one of the easiest buckets Iona's gotten here in the second half. And A.G., that's good defense. I know he unfortunately kicked it up into his face, but it's good reaction time as St. Peter's will inbound. Normally good hustles rewarded. A.G. that time got the brunt of a deflection. Unfortunate timing on this play.
Got his leg, foot in the passing lane area. That ball ricocheted right to his eye, but it looks like he's okay. He wouldn't dare come out of this basketball game now.
He's feeling it too. He's got 20. Turner gets just a moment of space, can't finish. Here comes Gist. Iona trying to retake the advantage. AG a little one-on-one with Idowu, backing him down. Going to the reverse side, and Iona back in front.
Big man basketball right there. AG going straight to the cup there. Able to use a nice spin move on the baseline using the weight of Idowu on him to spin and get that off the glass.
McGill steals the backdoor pass attempt. This is one of those potential runs that Iona goes on as they've retaken the lead.
And it starts with good defense.
And then AG's fouled by Idowu, and that is his fourth.
Again, this guy has a special talent, able to put it on the floor, and when he gets on a roll, he starts to feel it, and he can do a little bit of everything. That's why his disposition is so important. When he's into it, he's one of the best players in this league. Not on any all-conference team, but he has first-team talent.
One of four, Gale scoring in double figures, 13 a game. AG with a game-high 22 here this evening. Idowu has to sit with those four fouls, so they go right back to AG. Now checked by Woods. To the middle of the floor, AG will go to the line.
Great recognition, understanding. AG's on a roll. Woods just comes into the ball game, throw it right at him. Late double team comes over. He's able to go through the double team with strength.
Yeah, I know AG's not, he seems, I think, thinner, but say that to anyone playing him. He is as strong a big man, smooth. He seems to know how to use his body really well.
In our league, he's ideally a back-to-your-basket big, but he has a skill set where if he played at possibly the Big East or one of the power conferences, he would be considered a stretch four or a swing man, and his skill level is not quite there right now, but you know he can do it.
We've seen so many talented bigs come through Iona. You mentioned Jordan Washington.
Yes.
Let's take it back a couple years earlier. How about David Lowry?
Wow.
That's a fantastic player.
Remember Lowry bringing the basketball down to alleviate pressure. And I can see AG doing that. Again, he has another season. But this young man will definitely play somewhere at the next level.
An 8-0 run for Iona. One of those championship runs that they go on. Turner trying to answer. Woods down low. The third try and a foul.
Great job by St. Peter's on the glass. You would have loved Woods to put that in for an and one, but being aggressive, they're making their living in the paint.
An 8-0 Iona scoring run gives the Gales a three-point lead.
MJ?
My childhood, I need a little bit of that, but I need a little Boys to Men if we're going to Philly.
Let's keep it in Philly. Boys to Men, you got it. Jill Scott?
Always.
All right.
Always.
Classic.
We could go
that's
way
a,
back.
That's a classic block party.
You want to go way back?
Give me one more.
Billy Paul.
Woo!
I'm going way back, Philly.
Way back.
My radio, if someone gets in the car, I throw them off completely.
I love it.
They don't know what's coming at them.
Woods misses that first free throw. This is a big one. He needs to get something out of this trip down.
Big second one for Woods, and he makes it a two-point game. Woods is from Trenton. Is he allowed in the party?
Yes, definitely.
Okay. 7:45 to go. Iona up by two. Here's Crawford into Defoe. This is a really good matchup. And Crawford able to hit it over him.
Once again, that's too easy for Crawford, reminiscent of Carmelo Anthony. When he squares you up, gives you the jab step, puts you on the island, he can drive, he can pass it, or shoot it.
You give Crawford that much room to operate, he's so dangerous. Turner into the lane, needs help. Woods will try a free throw jumper, a huge shot for Derek Woods.
Big time shot by Derek Woods, knocks that down. I thought that was great defense by Ricky McGill on Turner.
Haven't mentioned Ricky McGill on this end of the floor in a while, and Nadefo put just a very slight touch on Crawford, but he got two hands on him for the foul.
That's a tough matchup for KC because Crawford is much stronger, and when they leave him on that island like that, he uses that rip through, and he's going strong to the cup. As a lefty, that's another advantage.
So Crawford, who shoots it well all over the place, 83% from the line. Another one coming. This one could make it a two-possession game with under seven left.
Crawford, one of Connecticut's finest.
Now you can't go to Hartford, not drop the name Crawford. That's good authority. His dad, the unofficial mayor of the city, and EJ following suit.
He gets a lot of love in Hartford. Watson may have gotten away with a push-off. Ricky McGill tried to sell it. The officials didn't buy.
Iona lead is four, and this game may be at one of those tipping points. Big possession for St. Peter's, and where do they go for the bucket? McGill hit the deck. Here's Watson. Oh, and he and Woods not on the same page, and they turn it over.
Watson got so deep he should have taken that when Woods wasn't ready.
McGill into the corner. Three from Rastanovich is too long, but there's AG. Oh, it's a deep one for Gist, and it's short.
St. Peter's dodged a bullet there. That's when I talked about controlling tempo and getting into a rhythm with attempts.
One of those threes falls. That's one of those back-breaking shots that Iona has specialized in this tournament. AG rebounding the Nadefo miss with 5:40 to go, and Iona will slow it up just a minute.
Talked about the demeanor of AG. Keep an eye on the demeanor of Casey. He's one of those guys who can get so high on the opposite end also. You want him to stay on a good, even keel.
AG all being aggressive, but too much spin down low. There's Woods able to play good defense and get the rebound.
AG with great footwork, unable to finish.
Couple of possessions in a row. Good looks for Iona, but it stays a four-point game.
Like to see Turner get a good look here if possible.
Taylor, oh, he throws one towards the basket. And there's AG down low again, his sixth rebound.
AG showing presence inside. Looks like he's tired.
He does, breathing heavy now as we come into the latter stages. 4:40 to go in the quarterfinal.
Most people don't realize when you're posting up banging against a big fella like Woods, it takes a lot out of you.
Gist into the lane. Three for McGill.
Excellent dribble drive action. Ricky McGill able to knock down the three, but Gist gets so deep in that lane.
And Shaheen Holloway takes timeout as Iona goes on one of their patented runs here in the MAAC tournament. Ricky McGill's three makes it 64-57. The Gales are used to being the only team left standing on Monday night. They're taking a big step to getting back there, Chris, as they've taken a 7-point lead here late in the second half.
Well, they had that spurt ability. We just saw that right before our eyes there, the ability to use their first team players to a T. Coming out of a timeout, you and I had discussed what are they going to do. They went right to Crawford. He was able to score the basketball from outside, and then go to the mid post, and then go deep down low. And then Ricky McGill knocks down the big three off the great penetration from Giss. So these guys are the ones who usually step up when Iona needs to get a run going.
Well, this was a tie game just a couple of minutes ago. That's what you said. The two all-league guys have to step up, and they've done that.
And have to give some credit to AG because he played well inside that post, giving you some good moves, not on any all-league team, however, but he plays with first-team talent.
Where does St. Peter's go for offense now as they haven't scored in over 3 minutes as Iona's built this 7-point lead?
Either go inside to Sam or Turner has to take a shot.
Dixon has taken some big shots here in the tournament, and he makes it 64-59.
And Dixon says, well, listen, Smooth, I'm taking a shot, and I'm going to make it.
He has not been afraid to take shots in big moments.
Nice mid-range jumper.
They throw it up to AG.
Great look. McGill, AG rolling to the basket. That gets him going. He throws it down with one hand.
Answering the St. Peter's bucket with authority. Idowu showing the big body down low.
And Casey the tried to come in with the rebound and stuff it with two hands. Timing just off a little bit.
Partner, we're firmly in. You called it yesterday. Winning time with Iona up seven.
This is when each possession becomes much more critical.
Oh, and a whistle. Nadefo will pick up his fourth foul.
St. Peter's foul number 11, Casey Nadefo. That's his fourth personal, team's ninth of the half.
Just a good read by Ricky McGill. AG using his bounce, all-league talent right there. No question, this guy could easily be on any all-conference team.
That's a tough angle to catch a lob at, too. That is a difficult play that AG made look really easy.
Again, this guy is so long, very good bounce. Watched him during warm-ups. He did a number of dunks that could possibly win a dunk contest.
They're coming at you right here.
Gives you a little added there afterwards.
Oh, he's got – his faces will make the all-face team.
You got it.
In this. 9-point Iona lead, and this is what they do. They eventually find either the weakness or they get to that breaking point in a game, and Iona seems to always have enough, Chris, to just push through when it matters most.
Well, St. Peter's is not going down. Dixon with a 3-pointer right in front of his bench. And these young guys from St. Peter's, meaning they're rookies, are playing big.
Manny Dixon again. 2-possession game, and St. Peter's says not so fast. And down low, here's Crawford again, 25.
Just tough to match up with him. When he gets you in that ISO, squares you up.
And Watson's going to pull it out, nearing the 2-minute mark in an 8-point game. A lot of ground to make up now for St. Peter's. Whistle on AG will be his third, and that will only be the fifth foul on Iona, so no free throws coming.
St. Peter's still battling. They're within punching position right now, only down by 8 points. But you question if they have enough to score quickly and get stops.
Watson will get it into Idowu. Turner coming around screens into the corner. His three is good.
Big time shot by Turner. I like the play called there to get him that look.
Difficult shot for Devontae Turner, and it's a 5-point game.
And the Iona guards are so strong with the basketball.
Gist into the corner. And Rastanovic will throw it down low. Agee getting right down to the block, and Idowu, a massive block shot.
Looks like Sam had all ball there. Agee has to get back on defense.
Turner wide open again. Two in a row for Devontae Turner.
Excellent transition opportunity there. Turner finding the open spot. That play was made because Sam runs the floor. Agee was behind at half court. They were in a number situation. Turner knocks down the three. 2-point ball game, 1:16 remaining.
We were counting this one off.
You were counting them out, buddy. I'm trying to give you. Listen, man, there's a lot of time left.
It's tough when Iona takes a lead to not think anything but how about the resolve of St. Peter's and Devontae Turner?
Watson, good decision there, finding his backcourt mate in transition. The previous set play going over top, two knockdowns. Now he's in a good rhythm, Turner, able to knock down some big shots. My question was, could they score quickly and get some stops? Transition opportunities, knocking down the three ball. You have a 2-point basketball game.
Minute 16 left. Turner has been in the middle of everything for St. Peter's all season, but especially in this tournament. He's the reason they pulled it out in the second half and overtime against Marist, and he's the reason we have a one possession game.
We said that in our previous game. You want your stars to shine in games like this. You want them to have the opportunity. As much as we like the young guys from St. Peter's and you want them to take and make big shots, but when you have all league players, those are the guys you want in their hands. Let them create. If the young fellas are gonna take shots, it has to be off a feed from Turner, off a feed from Sam, where they're benefiting from your all-league type players doing what they do well. On the flip side, Iona, cool as a fan. They're gonna come back out, most likely McGill, Crawford. They're gonna get a touch to get this thing started, and if they need to go down low, Agee has an opportunity. But keep an eye on Agee's disposition. I can't say it enough. He thought he got fouled on the other end. That's why he was late getting down to the defensive end. So they may not go to him. His spirits might not be into it.
Well, here's the one thing I know. The pulse of Ricky McGill probably hasn't changed all game, right? He's the cool customer, the winner. Right now, this is as real as it gets here with a minute 16 left in a 2-point game.
And keep in mind, Iona's leading. They're not down.
McGill going to catch, going to go to the basket. There he is.
You called it. We saw that play earlier. It comes to Ricky. He makes a quick move going to his left, but the light floater with his right hand off the glass.
Inside of a minute, 72-68. Turner's made two threes in a row. One was contested, one open. McGill's face guarding him in the left corner. Here he is. Turner with five on the clock. To the crossover, another three. Turner three threes in the last couple of possessions, and it's 72-71.
Agee did a really good job coming out to make Turner step back, but he gives you a good move to make space and knocks down the three over the big guy.
5 seconds the difference between the game and the shot clock. St. Peter's is going to play it out. Gist will give it up to Crawford with five on the clock. He'll go to the basket. The shot missed, loose ball. Idowu clears it, and a foul is called on Tawan Agee.
Wow.
It's only the sixth Iona foul, so no free throws, but St. Peter's will get it with 5.2 left and a chance to win this game.
Get the ball to Crawford. Good move going to his left. Help side defense right there by Big Sam. You like Crawford going to the left. Those are shots he can take. But again, enough there defense where that ball is short and Sam can come up with the rebound. Oftentimes, when you come over with the help side trying to get that block, that's an excellent opportunity for Agee to get that rebound. But that shot was short. Sam able to contest it and get the rebound. St. Peter's 5.2 remaining has an opportunity to close out this basketball game.
What an unbelievable finish that. We have 60-second timeout on the court. Iona was up 8 points, partner, just a very short while ago. And on the back of three threes from Devontae Turner, it is a one-point game, and now the Peacocks have a chance to steal a quarterfinal game.
Well, the good thing that St. Peter's has going for him on this last possession, because Turner has knocked down his last three attempts, he's coming off screens most likely. So you're thinking you're going to have to run at him. If you're running at him, I'm thinking going to that basket. I want Turner playing downhill. I want him getting that basketball. If he comes off of a screen, your Iona defender, you don't want him to shoot the basketball. He's good enough to go off the bounce, get in that lane, create something, put the onus on these officials right now.
If you're Iona, right, there's the one guy you can't have beat you is Turner, but we have seen Dixon take and make some big shots, and Watson as well in this tournament has shown that he's not afraid to take it.
As much as I like those guys, Eddie,
yeah,
as much as they've stepped up, Turner has to get this basketball in his hands. I'm going to take a guess that Ricky McGill will try to guard him and deny him, but I want Turner touching this basketball.
St. Peter's has made four in a row, including three triples from Devontae Turner. So Quinn Taylor will inbound the length of the floor. St. Peter's does have one timeout left if they need it. Now Iona will take its last timeout after seeing the initial alignment that St. Peter's came out in.
Well, the one thing St. Peter's has to do is, we've just noticed, they have to take it the length of the floor. 5.2 remaining is plenty of time. But again, in college basketball, oftentimes you have guys panic.
1 point Iona lead with just over 5 seconds left. And Chris, Turner hit three in a row, this one the most recent.
Good move to create that space. Again, the big fella on his heels. Turner able to rock back, knocks down that three right in front of the basket. Probably the easiest three for most guards to make.
There's not enough adjectives to describe the will of this St. Peter's team. Coming back, veterans. They picked off Marist yesterday. They're trying to knock off the top seed for the second year in a row.
Now, it looks like Iona's a little confused on the defensive end. Turner's taking that ball out, but again, I'm guessing that he needs to get it right back.
He'll inbound the ball, and he'll get a free run at it. Idowu gives it back to him. Here comes Turner, and he's fouled! Turner is fouled just above the three-point line by AG, and he'll have 1-1 with 2 seconds left.
Eddie, coming out defensively, I did not like that setup at all. There seemed to be a lot of confusion from Iona because Turner was taking the ball out of bounds. They were out of position. He gets it right back. They had to foul him.
What a sequence. That foul not only will send Devontae Turner to the line for 1-1, it fouls out Tawan Agee with 26 points.
Again, you get the ball to Sam, you know it's coming back to Turner, so that puts AG in a position where he's on his heel backpedaling, and he reaches out, he's called for the foul, and like you said, that's it for him for the night, but it's only 2 seconds remaining.
So AG and his game high 26 over on the bench. Now it's not two, it's 1-1 for Turner. St. Peter's leading scorer shoots 80% from the free throw line.
Big free throw here. Oftentimes when a player has made three-pointers, you don't want them going to the free throw line shooting long shots.
Huge free throws for the senior. His first one. Pulls the string. There's a jump ball on the rebound, and it'll be Iona ball. Oh, Turner's been fantastic all second half. And he misses the front end, and Iona will inbound with 0.8 seconds left.
Wow, that's so disappointing. Turner at the free throw line, an 80% shooter. That ball rattles in and out. But on that rebound, it looks like KC had the inside position.
And the inbounds to Crawford, who's fouled immediately. It'll be Nadefo's fifth foul, and now E.J. Crawford will go to the line, as it'll be two free throws for the junior. And, oh, partner, I don't know about you, but the way that Turner's played, you can't help but feel for him in that moment.
Well, I love his reaction here. The young man is still playing with a lot of composure, but I made a great point before he went to the free throw line. That shot goes all the way on. After shooting long shots, making that adjustment at the free throw line is more mental than anything. And as a player, you probably can understand that more. Going up to that free throw, he's made three three-pointers in a row. So your long-range shooting ability is on mark. But going to that free throw line, you have to make that adjustment, and sometimes it can be difficult.
So two for Crawford, and he misses one. Now there's 4:10 left. St. Peter's does have a timeout, but
now
with
Crawford might be better off missing this free throw.
I was going to say, with just 4:10 left, let's see what E.J. Crawford does. And he's going to make it to make it 73-71. And St. Peter's will take its final timeout. Now Shaheen Holloway's got to bring the troops over, settle everyone down, and partner, try and draw something up. Not a whole lot of time in which to operate.
Well, 0.5, not sure if you can get a really good one off in that short amount of time, especially if you're taking out underneath your basket. The only thing I'm thinking of is something long on a tip-in, if possible.
You know, teams have plays like this for this scenario. And like you said, it's kind of been a roller coaster of emotions these last couple of possessions, hasn't it?
Well, again, this closeout has really been taxing on your nerves if you're a St. Peter's fan or an Iona fan. As a broadcaster, it's like, wow, you feel for the young man going to that free throw line. But again, you want to close out this basketball game and try to make this a game and win it if you can.
Well, every title run has those moments. Can St. Peter's pull off a stunner with 0.4? Rastanovic will guard the ball. Taylor will inbound. He's going to have to throw it over the 6'9" Andrea Rastanovic. And there's the deflection. And that will, well, I thought, end the game. It says there's 1:10 left. So we'll probably see the same thing that we would have seen.
Great job putting the big fellow on the basketball. That's the reason that's done, because of that play.
And it's 1:10. All you can do at 1:10 is tip it in. So Taylor throws the touchdown pass. Idowu makes the catch, and Iona will survive. The top seed and three-time defending champions, Iona Gales, take St. Peter's best punch, and they advance 73-71 into Sunday's semifinals.